Hey everyone, today I'll show you how to remove Android from your iWork 10 tablet so you can use all the space for Windows only. First you need to get this software. It's free, just run it. Edition, choose free. You can change this if you want. And just press download. After it finished downloading, just install it. The software allows you to backup your entire disk into a file, so you can later restore your tablet. I will be using this to just restore Windows and not Android. There is other ways to do it, like just delete partitions, but then you can't expand the C drive because there is an unformatted partition of Windows, this one, and you can't move it with at least software I tried. First you need to choose where you want to place it. You can backup anywhere you want. I will backup my image to my server. You can just backup to a flash drive or an external hard drive. You can choose what you want. So what you have to do, you go there, disk image, and you click image this disk. Now you can see already here. Now make sure the checkbox is selected, so all of the partitions are going to be backed up. If you want to check Windows, it's the last four partitions, this one, this, and this, and this. The other ones are Android. I will backup everything anyways, in case I later want to restore it. You just press next. You don't need to change anything here, you just press next. Now it will show what it's going to do. Just click finish. You can uncheck the second option if needed and click OK. Now you just have to wait. Meanwhile, let's do something important. You should have that Switch Now app in your desktop. You can just open it. When it asks if you want to switch to Android, just click No and then select Disable right here. After you click Disable, just click Exit. This is to disable that boot menu you see when you boot up the tablet. It shows Windows or Android with a timer. This disables it. It's almost done. Just a few seconds. So, there you go. There you go. Image completed. Now, you all need a flash drive. A small one. Boot from. I'll be using 1 GB drive. I'm going to plug it in my dock. If you don't have a dock, you can just use the USB OTG adapters and the Type-C adapters to do the same thing. So now we have to create a rescue media. You go to other tasks and create rescue media. You just click that. It might say you need to download something, just download it and you'll get to this window. Just click next. Next, no problems there. Just click next. It will start doing something. As I said, we'll be using a USB device. Just select your USB drive. It should show up here. This one is already done, so it doesn't work, but it should be fine. If you have problems, let me know. Now, everything is done here. You can close this up. The tricky part begins. You should have your flash drive that you gonna need to boot. And then, depending on what you selected, you'll have other flash drive that has the image of your disk or something else, hard drive, whatever. Just note that I'm using network to save the image, but I'm not using wireless. I'm using Ethernet adapter this one. I'm using this with the Type-C adapter. Yes, I showed this adapter before, so I'm just using this one. You can also use the other one, which I might start to use since I'm almost out of battery. You can also use the provided one. It's only USB 2 speeds, but it should be good enough as well. I'm going to switch to this one now. I might want to charge the tablet while I do this. I'm just going to plug it in to charge. Now, what you have to do now is reboot. Select reboot. Just reboot Windows. You'll need a keyboard for this. If you don't have a dock like I have, you can use any USB keyboard. Just plug it in to the USB port on the tablet. You might have to use a USB app to plug in all this stuff. So I'm plugging in, plug it in, flash drive, rebooting. After the tablet reboots, just smashed escape key. It should come up with a BIOS screen where you can select your USB device. There you go, this is the BIOS. Now, you just use the left and right arrow keys and go to the Save and Exit tab. Here at Boot Override, you should be able to see your USB flash. Press Enter. Now it should be booting from the flash drive. There it goes. Booting up. There it is. So now I'm going to plug in my Ethernet adapter, since I'm using network. You might plug in your flash drive or whatever. In the disk image tab, you can see your current installation on the tablet. Still has all these things. You remember, you just clicked here before. Now we are going to restore. What we are going to do is browse for an image file. Now, if you have a flash drive, it will show up here. You can select it. I'm using network, so I have to go to network and go to my server. There you go. I have it on my tablet folder, new to, and here it is, 25.6 gigabytes. Let me open it. There you go. The image is here, the date, you can see it much when I made the video. Now, restore image is what you want. It's right there. Now, pay attention. This is your current installation on the tablet. This is the backup we made a few minutes before. In the backup, you remember, we included Android and Windows. That's why there is so many partitions. So on the backup, on the top, just scroll to the right and should have recovery, last one, Windows C, unformatted primary, and 4032 system drive. These are the four we are going to restore. It's Windows 10 partitions. The rest, it's all Android partitions, and we are not going to use them. At the bottom, just click on the first one. Doesn't matter. Just click delete existing partition. Keep clicking until you don't have any partitions on the bottom. Just keep doing it. Delete. There you go. It's all free space. 58.24 gigabytes. Whatever. Just drag it. Yeah. I've been here the last 15 minutes and this didn't work. And now it just started working. Just. Yeah, I don't know. It seems the way I drag it sometimes. Oh, see? Now it works. Now it doesn't? No. It seems. Just keep dragging it. See? It just works when it wants to work. This is really strange. Just select this one here. Just click it one time. Just go to restore partition properties and just make sure the free space in megabytes is 1000. this makes the partition bigger, as you can see, it's 57 gigabytes partition. Now it's bigger. Now you only have this little bit here, that's for the recovery partition. When it is there something blinking? Is there like, there you go, finally. So now you can see how it's going to do it. The system partition, this is the main Windows partition. Now you can see it's going to be 57.15 gigabytes, and the recovery partition 1 gigabyte, the moment of truth. Okay, just click next, click finish, and hope for the best. Loading times will be overwritten. Let's continue. Let's hope everything goes well. So this is now restoring the image we made earlier, just the Windows partitions. Done. You can upload, you can go to disk image again, and you can see the current disk only has the 4 partitions we selected. And now I'm going to close this window, and the tablet should reboot. When it reboots, I'm going to remove the boot flash drive. Come on, you can do it. That's a good sign. It seems to be. Let's go. Please, don't you screw me. Ooh. There we go. And there we go. Windows is now booted. Let me show you the partitions. C drive has all the available space. I can also show you the disk manager if you want. Disk manager, there you go. There you go, disk manager. You can see the 4 partitions and the big Windows partition and nothing else. Let's check here. It's the first time I did that. I didn't know if it was going to work or not. I just tried. You can see the partitions, system, the strange 16 megabytes partition, Windows, and recovery. Let me know in the comments if you have any problems. Of course, I can't be responsible if you screw up your tablet. Thanks for watching. Comment, subscribe, like the video, and I see you on the next video. Bye!